go into like 10 movement mobility series. Then it's test week, so we're trying to test the waters. There's a lot of ways we can test it. Basically, pushing power, a lot of that today. Let's start off with this child's rock. Big toes when you get a knee apart. Back there, a few neck downs, shoulders are low, side roll here. So I've got my legs spread apart, folding my knees, just rocking left and right. Style. So arm straight, knees bent, reaching the opposite arm and leg away, just the one side for a few reps. Keeping a little back press to the ground. Dial back in, switch to the side. Hang out on the elbows, kind of moving my shoulders a little bit, stretching out, gently belly muscles. And you can just press the shoulders away from the ears and let them shrug in a few times. Try doing the shoulders, the head will stay still, just the shoulders slip and slide in a circular motion. A little bit of squat. Right. Let's see what else we got on tap. Let's hit the lights on. Just a little hip circle like a dog. Pee on a fire hydrant. Lift and then draw circles one direction. In the other direction. Slightly easier version would be, as opposed to lifting it out to the side, just lift it off the ground, like an etch-a-sketch, draw a circle just right underneath you. Other direction. Back to the Seiza sit, a little shake out in the hands, arms, get that little jiggle. Back into the position we're in, kick out one leg, just on the big toe side of the foot. So it's like a kickstand, out on one side. Then, rocking, gently forward and back. Try being bent leg, being flat footed or toe top, or to a little between. Shake out the arms, especially the wrists, fingers, elbows. Alright. Next one, let's do cat-cow. Just go with cat-cow with a breath match. Exhales on the ground. Inhales and extension, nose. Yeah, they're looking behind. Seiza, shake out. This is our moments for any kind of upper shoulders. You can do a few ups and overs behind, swing backs, back strokes. Same thing in the other direction, forward. Reaching behind, chin first, top forward. One is lizard stretch. You're in the crawl position. Try bringing your right foot as close as you can to your right hand. And then I like to put my right hand on top of that lead. Right knee helps me draw some simple small circles around the ankle. Just another direction. Idea is to tuck the toes of the left leg in the back. Try to straighten out that leg. Then bend the back and forward. Tuck the toes and straighten out the back leg. You can actually come down a little bit behind you. Then drop the knee and forward. Just feel out those different strokes. Straighten the eyes back, eyes forward. So really good for strict press, deadlifts. You really want to stand in the room for straight leg. Downshift, upshift, gently, tall, back down a few times. Open it up. Seiza. Going out there for a moment, going for a little bit of wrist mobility, elbows of the cavern. More here. Let's do actually back into that position where you have the right foot, right hand. And then reach your right hand to your chest. chest, up to the sky, switch your trigger, and upper back, easy breath. Switch sides of the back. Right on. Let's do here, down dog, mainly just focusing on the buttock and air position, so springing yourself back up that butt, your head, your chest keeps going hands over your shoulders, your head and your shoulders and this top like spinning motion. ourselves into the deepest spot you can just from the floor. So typically that's kind of like what we're doing earlier. You might bring one foot next to the hand and then the other. And then sitting into an easy squat, just breathing here. Breath in, breath out. Shakeout drills, orientation back to the other disorder would come up really fast. We're feeling so far.